Hello, my name is Emmanuel. This is Tackle. And this is a different episode of Tackle. We're calling it EPL for Dummies. No, for beginners.
He's a dummy.
EPL for beginners. I'm a beginner. We're going to talk about all the things that people who are not into football or who are trying to find their way into the EPL, into football, what they need to know and how to maneuver the way. Because there's like a mountain of information that people need to know. But something that can start someone like me off so that I can get into it for, you know, the entire tournament. Is it a tournament or is it a season?
It's a season.
It's a season for the entire season, kind of like a movie, like a TV show. Anyway, so yes, that's what I know. So that's what this episode is going to be about. So I'm going to start off by asking one question. What is the English Premier League?
The English Premier League, one of the oldest competitions you'd have in football. You know, it's a league that has 20 teams in there, mm-hmm. playing 38 games each. Mm-hmm. And it's a league that, you know, draws a lot of fans from across the world.
Okay.
Millions, billions of fans, depending on which season is being played. And of course, what mm-hmm. draws them, you know, to the league. It's got so many superstars in there. It is basically the English version of the Ghana Premier League,
okay.
that is more expanded, that is, you know, better organized,
okay.
that is, you know, well pumped with a lot of cash. I mean, a lot of cash. A lot of people say it is the richest league in world football, and that's because of the proper marketing that goes into it.
I see.
So, yeah, it's arguably the best league in the world.
So, I want to get into that. I want to start watching the English Premier League, the EPL. How do I choose my favorite team?
It's very simple. You either want to go as a populist and follow the masses, or okay. you might just want to get yourself an island and just support the odd team. So the favorite clubs there yes. are Manchester United. They are the most successful club in the English Premier League,
okay.
Winning over 20 EPL titles. Liverpool are second in there. These days, they're not exactly successful mm-hmm. on the Premier League front. The last time they won it was way back in the 90s. They haven't won it again.
Okay.
Man United have actually been the most successful in the modern mm-hmm. era, and in the history of the tournament as okay. well. Chelsea have become a huge favorite in recent times. And that is
Chelsea, that's where Michael Essien used to
play. That's what Michael Essien used to play.
Okay.
And that's, I mean, Michael Essien arrived at Chelsea in 2006, and that was some 3 years after Roman Abramovich had bought the club.
Right.
Now, okay. to give you some history to Chelsea, they were a club that were mid-table. They were a mid-table club. They weren't always relegated. They weren't winning the title. Mm-hmm. They were always hanging in there. I mean, before Roman Abramovich, the Russian oligarch, had bought this club, Chelsea had won the league only in 1955. Mm-hmm. I mean, they were a side that weren't really going to bother those at the top.
I see.
But we're just dealing slowly and subtly, you know, with some of the big boys until the Russian pumped in his money. The likes of Didier Drogba, Michael mm-hmm. Essien, Frank Lampard, okay. and a lot of these guys, got into the league. I mean, got into the club and made it the kind of club that we've come to see
okay.
in recent times. So it is another one that okay. you can support. If you're watching from Africa, it's got a huge fan base from Africa.
Okay.
And that is because it is the one club that had so many Africans in there. You okay. can mention Michael Essien, our own. You can mention Didier Drogba. You can mm-hmm. mention Salomon Kalou, Jean-Michel Obi. So many of them. So mm-hmm. many of them. Recently, we've had Abdoulaye Rahman, also a Chelsea player. He's on loan, actually. We had okay. Victor Moses as well. So many Africans. Samuel Eto'o has also had some stints in there. I'm mentioning some players who, if you're familiar with football, would know, obviously,
I think
became popular because of Chelsea.
In Ghana, most of the big teams that I've heard of, it's Chelsea, Arsenal, and Manchester United.
I was coming to Arsenal. Arsenal are a great club.
Okay.
Thing with them is they have been quite unsuccessful in the last few years. And Arsene Wenger, he left the club last season after 22
years
in charge.
I'm not following Arsenal then.
You're not following. You could just follow. You could follow. I mean, no Arsenal fights there for those of you watching if you're a Ghana. I'm just saying, they're just not the successful club that you want to support in recent times.
Okay.
But they are one of the big traditional clubs that are immensely successful when you look at history.
Okay.
But in recent times, you might look at Manchester City, mm-hmm. a club that is currently being led into modern success by the genius in current world football.
Okay.
They call him Pep Guardiola. He galvanized Barcelona to get them to become the club they are in world football. So he's moved from Barcelona to Bayern Munich, and then he's now at Manchester United. He's gotten them to win the league and win some domestic trophies as well. I'm talking about Guardiola that is livening and changing philosophies in the English Premier League.
I see.
So I've mentioned Manchester City, I've mentioned Chelsea, I've mentioned Manchester United, I've mentioned Liverpool and Arsenal. These are the traditional clubs that you might want to support. Manchester City just came into the picture. It was a top four, the traditional top four that ruled for over two decades were Manchester United, Liverpool, Chelsea and Arsenal. These were the top sides. Then Manchester City entered to make it a top five. Then Tottenham Hotspur entered. Tottenham Hotspur are the club that will not exactly win any trophy. They will not be relegated as well. But they are always dealing big, big, big blows to the top boys.
Right.
So the top four in the English Premier League, when you look at the table after every season, are the sides that will be moving to the UEFA Champions League.
Right, okay.
So regularly, these four teams that I mentioned as a big four were those that were making the top four. But Manchester City has disrupted that, and then Tottenham Hotspur these days as well. So for example, last season, Manchester City won the title. Manchester United were second. And remember, these two are in the city of Manchester.
Yeah.
So there's big rivalry between them. And I'll be talking about rivalries very soon. You look at a side like Liverpool that were third. Then Tottenham Hotspur were fourth. Manchester City were first. Tottenham Hotspur were fourth. And they have displaced Arsenal and Chelsea, who placed sixth and fifth respectively, who could have and should have, on the traditional basis, been in the top four. But these days, it is a big struggle between between the top six, all managed by top-class coaches. Manchester United is managed by Jose Mourinho, one of the perennial winners, wins almost every time.
Okay.
Manchester City, like I mentioned, managed by Pep Guardiola. So there's Mauricio Sarri. He's the coach of Tottenham Hotspur. He's been that for the last 3 years or so. And he's gotten them to become the club that they are these days, using youth and blending with a bit of experience, getting them where they are. For Arsenal, they are managed by a new coach, Unai Emery. He's moved from Paris Saint-Germain from the French league to the English league this summer. And then this summer, Chelsea have had a new coach as well, sacking Antonio Conte and bringing in an Italian boss, Maurizio Sarri.
Okay.
Liverpool, coached by Jurgen Klopp. Now, let's move to the rivalries, because this is where it gets really interesting for those who really, really support the club. Now, all these clubs are national rivals.
Okay.
National rivals. So they hate each other, because then they are the sides that are battling for the one trophy, the English Premier League. Of course, the other trophies like the English FA Cup, which is the oldest traditional cup, in world football, all over the world. It is the oldest knockouts competition. You know, so we meet, I beat you, I move on to the next team, I beat the next team, I move on to the next team. That is not a league. A league is all play all, where I play 38 games, 19 first round, and then another 19 second round. So it's a home and away fixture.
Okay.
The FA Cup is what we say here, pick and crying. I meet you, I beat you, and I move forward. The winner moves forward.
Okay.
And the winners keep facing each other until we have an eventual winner. That is the FA Cup. Okay. But the league, obviously, like I explained, is an all play all. 19 first, 19 second.
So how does that 38, work? You rack up points?
You rack up points. Okay. 3 points per game.
Okay.
If you draw, it's 1 point. If you lose, it's no point.
Okay.
So whoever finishes the season with the most points has won the league. It's that simple.
Does playing home and away make a difference? Or you don't do that in the EPL?
No, you do that everywhere, in every league. Home and away is definitely very important. But thing here is, there is a lot of difference if you play at home, especially in a league like the English Premier League. The reason I'm saying this is the home support is great. This is a league that is watched. Every single game is really watched. So you'd have very unfancy teams like Wolverhampton Wanderers and Bolton Wanderers or Leicester City playing against each other. And these stadiums are going to be full to capacity. So if you're playing at home, you have the comfort of the 12 man, the fans. If you're playing away, you know your back is against the wall. You definitely are fighting, against the wall of Jericho.
Yeah.
I'm talking about knowing that you are fighting against an opposition that has a full force coming at you, including the fans, booing every one of your moves that you make in their away grounds. But I was talking about the rivalries, remember?
Yes.
So in London, There are several teams in the English Premier League, and I'll just mention those that I can remember. There's Chelsea at West London. Mm-hmm. There's Tottenham Hotspur in North London. There's Arsenal in North London. There's Crystal Palace at West London. There is West Ham United at East London. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. Now, these are five clubs in London alone mm-hmm. that are battling against each other in the English Premier League. Now, Chelsea's direct rival mm-hmm. over there then would be Crystal Palace, just because of proximity. Okay. There's Fulham as well. Fulham is also, so that's six clubs. Fulham is in West London. And Fulham is just like a stone throw from Stamford Bridge, mm-hmm. which is the home of Chelsea. Mm-hmm. Fulham's stadium is Craven Cottage, just for those who want to remember. Now, these are the direct rivals, town rivals, okay? City rivals, if you want to call them. If you go to East London, there's West Ham United. Mm-hmm. In the English Premier League, that's the top flight, mm-hmm. first division. They are the only club representing from the East London.
Okay.
In North London, there's Arsenal. There's Arsenal and Tottenham Hotspur, and they are fierce rivals.
Rivals, okay.
And that's because they are in the same city, okay, from the same part of the city, I should say, mm-hmm. and they are battling against each other mm-hmm. for who is the most supreme club in that part of the world. But the biggest clubs, okay, in London, mm-hmm. obviously, because of trophies, fan base, money, and everything put together, is Arsenal and Chelsea.
Okay.
Okay? So that is how the rivalries go. If you go to Liverpool, for instance, they are based in Merseyside. Now, that's the same city where Everton also come from. And that is proper rivalry between the two. But Liverpool are the most successful. They are considered the biggest club in Merseyside. Mm-hmm. Everton come in second. They occupy Goodison Park. Right. That's their stadium. Anfield is their home of Liverpool. If you go to the city of Manchester, there's Manchester United that has been the most dominant club in Manchester throughout football. And then there is the new guy, mm-hmm. Manchester City. They've been there, but they have not exactly set the world stage alight mm-hmm. until recent times. Mm-hmm. So then now they consider themselves, proper rivals of Manchester. But Manchester United, mm-hmm. the biggest rivalry in the English Premier League, and this is key, the biggest rivalry in the English Premier League is Manchester United against Liverpool. And that is really? Simply because they are the most successful clubs in the English game.
Okay.
You can mention the likes of Arsenal who would come in. So Arsenal against Manchester United is another top one. Chelsea against Liverpool is a top club, and that's because of recent meetings have mm-hmm. been bloody. Manchester United and Chelsea as well. Mm-hmm. Meeting not just in the English Premier League, meeting in the Champions League has made some of these meetings and some of these encounters very, very, very hot.
I see. So for example, if you're talking about rivalries.
Yeah.
What should I look out for if I want to choose a favorite team or a team to follow?
A team that wins. For, a team that will bring you smiles. For people who love arguments,
yes.
for the argument type of football fans, mm-hmm. if you want to enter the English Premier League, mm-hmm. you need to look out for a club that would give you these things. A club that has a rich history,
mm-hmm.
which means that you can obviously always fall back on the trophies you've won mm-hmm. and win your arguments.
Okay.
A club that boasts of good commercial value, mm-hmm. like Manchester United, they are arguably the richest club in the world, mm-hmm. comparing themselves with the likes of Manchester United, with Real Madrid and Bayern Munich, of Spain and Germany, respectively.
Okay.
If you're looking for top history, Liverpool counted as well, mm-hmm. Arsenal counted. If you're looking for modern success where you can associate with the success, you know, you can support Liverpool mm-hmm. and you can never really know who was a top goal scorer when they won their last league title,
right?
Because it's such a long time ago. But if you want to associate with modern success, mm-hmm. there's Manchester City, there's mm-hmm. Chelsea currently rubbing shoulders with Manchester United with the number of certain trophies won, mm-hmm. makes them a huge club. One person gets into the league, pumps so much money, so many world-class players enter this one club, mm-hmm. they win series of trophies, and suddenly the world of football is just looking at this club, Chelsea, and saying, hey, we need to set up and rewrite our notes when we want to face Chelsea. Similar plot has been taken up by Manchester City. So I'm talking about mm-hmm. I'm talking about knowing what exactly you want.
Okay.
If you want to associate with history,
I want to associate with people like alike underdogs. So people who...
You like underdogs. So the president of this country supports Tottenham Hotspur.
Okay.
They are not exactly...
Ekufo-Addo is a Tottenham Hotspur
exactly.
fan. Okay.
He's not... I mean, Ekufo-Addo is supporting Tottenham just because he based there for a while. But, you know, Spurs are not exactly, like I told you, the most successful club. Okay. They are not going to be winning the title.
They won't win it.
They boast the best striker in the Premier League, mm-hmm. according to many, Harry Kane these days. And it becomes the individual stars that people can also identify with. Harry Kane is the best striker, lots of people say, in the last 3 years in the English Premier League. Mm-hmm. He's from Tottenham Hotspur. Mm-hmm. Some of the best defenders, some of the best midfielders are there at Tottenham. They never win the Premier League. They never win the FA Cup. Oh. They never win the EFL Cup, which happens to be the smallest of the domestic trophies. Okay. But they are always up there in the semi-final, mm-hmm. in the latter stages, fighting for trophies. So if you're looking for an underdog, maybe they could qualify for one. Or maybe you can look for some of these clubs where Ghanaians play at. Mm-hmm. So, there's Leicester City where Daniel Amate plays at. He's a midfielder cum defender. Against Manchester United last weekend, he played as a right back. Leicester City, they won the trophy against all odds. And if you're looking for the best underdog, maybe it's them. Because they won a trophy against all odds in 2016. No one expected them to win.
Leicester City?
Yes, no one expected them to win.
Okay.
They have a Ghanaian flavor in there. They have an African flavor as well. The likes of Iheanacho. Riyad Mahrez used to play there. These days, he plays at Manchester City and all. Wilfred Ndidi, a Nigerian, also plays there. Okay. Swansea City, well, these days they're in the Championship, so let's forget them. They had their use.
Okay.
Now, the younger of their use, that's Jordan, his moved to one of the London clubs I mentioned, Crystal Palace. And that's another club you can support because they're a proper underdog. They never really win.
Okay.
They win when they have to. They find a way to accrue a lot of points to remain in the Premier League, and that's sufficient for them. They don't battle for trophies. They know their place. So you have Jordan Ayew playing for them. You have Jeffrey Schlupp, another Ghana defender, cum winger, mm-hmm. playing for them. He scored a goal this weekend as well. So Crystal Palace is one of the teams you can look out for. Everton, very, very strong underdog.
Mm-hmm.
So I mentioned the top six these days.
Yes.
Everton are like the seventh club.
Okay.
So they are an underdog. They never really are in the top four. Mm-hmm. They are never really near relegation. Remember, three teams mm-hmm. every season would go on relegation. That is, they'll be demoted to the second tier of English football.
All right.
And then three from English second tier football, they call the Championship, will now be promoted to the Premier League.
Okay.
You get it. So that's how the demotion promotion works. Now, Everton never get near demotion or relegation, as it's properly called.
Okay.
But they are a proper underdog, just like others like Southampton. Stoke City was a proper mainstay for over 10 years until they were relegated just last season.
Right.
They would have been another top club you could have invested in. That is.
Okay. So I think maybe I'm leaning towards Leicester City.
Leicester City.
Yes,
proper underdog. Leaning. You're an underdog guy.
Yeah.
Anyway,
so
let me just briefly mention some of the stars in English football. I mean, a lot of people know about the Cristiano Ronaldos and Lionel Messi's. And they say, well, that's all football has to offer. No, in the English Premier League, there are lots of giants in there. I mentioned Harry Kane. He's an English guy, English striker. He's a young striker, 25, 24 years. Scoring loads of goals in recent years. He's scored over 100, both club and international, in the last 3 years. You mentioned he plays for Tottenham Hotspur. Mm-hmm. At Manchester United, the likes of Romelu Lukaku, he's another young striker, a Belgium international. You mentioned Alexis Sanchez, Juan Mata, Paul Pogba. So many of the stars in there. If you go to Manchester City, that's where all the big stars are.
Mm-hmm.
Pep Guardiola has assembled a lot of great guys. Kevin De Bruyne, considered the best midfielder in the Premier League these days. Sergio Kun Aguero, one of the best strikers the Premier League has ever seen. He's actually one of the top goal scorers in the history of the Premier League. You mentioned Gabriel Jesus, Riyad Mahrez, who moved from Leicester City to Man City a few weeks ago. David Silva, Bernardo Silva, a lot of players. If you go to Chelsea, there is Eden Hazard, considered the best player ever in the Premier League. Now currently among the players that are in the league at the moment. Eden Hazard, considered the best player. You can mention Alvaro Morata, N'Golo Kante, the most humble guy you'd ever meet in football. The guy dresses anyhow. Well, it's perfect for him, but he can wear jeans, pants, shorts to a wedding, and doesn't really care about it. Trophy celebrations, he's isolated. He smiles when he's called on to hold a trophy. You know, this is a proper humble guy. Mm-hmm. He's considered also one of the best midfielders in the Premier League, N'Golo Kante. Has African roots. He plays for France. Won the World Cup just a few months ago.
What's the team in the EPL?
Chelsea. He plays for Chelsea. The likes of Willian, the likes of Pedro, David Luiz, a star defender, that is. And then you go to Liverpool. Mohamed Salah, the Egyptian hero. He is considered one of the best players these days, competing with Ronaldo and Lionel Messi just for the blistering last season he had last year. He scored 44 goals.
So I kept hearing about him during the last season. Yeah. Mo Salah.
Brilliant. He's a winger forward, cool, very fast, nimble footed, and he knows exactly where to get, when to get past his man and when to hit a shot to get a goal. And he does that effortlessly. Last weekend, he scored a goal in his first game this season as well.
So how would you advise that I watch the English Premier League? Should I watch, like, it's every Friday, TV. Saturday, Sunday, right?
It's actually Saturday, Sunday mostly. There's Monday night football.
Okay.
And then in recent times, they've added Friday night football.
Okay.
So last Friday, there was one game at the Old Trafford, and that was the opening game between Manchester United and Leicester. Okay. A lot of games on Saturday and Sunday, because that's when you get a lot of people watching. Mm-hmm. And then, just to also engage some more people who are free on Mondays and to also push the games over to the weekdays as well. There's Monday night football, 8 p.m. kickoff. The Saturday kickoff usually is at 11:30 a.m. Mm-hmm. There is a 3 p.m. kickoff and there's a 5 p.m. kickoff. Mm-hmm. So those are the kickoff times.
Do I watch all the matches? Like, do I just sit and watch from 11? Or do I have to follow?
You just have to follow the big sides and follow the team you want. So if you are supporting Manchester United, you're watching Chelsea, Liverpool, Man City, and Arsenal, because these are your direct rivals. You need to know what exactly they're doing, who are their best players and stuff like that. You can decide not to watch them full games. You can just watch highlights.
Okay.
of those games and follow the commentary, because they come with a lot of history. They come with a lot of information that you might want to get, looking at this or watching the English Premier League. And it's really exciting getting to know when someone scores, getting to know that he's scoring for the first time in 2.5 years, playing over 4,000 minutes and still had not scored a goal until now. It's very intriguing knowing when you marry the smile and the celebration on the from the player who scored the goal, and you get the commentary and the history to that particular goal, you fully appreciate why the person is celebrating the way he's celebrating, and why I remember when when John McKelvey scored a goal for Chelsea, he had been the first time in over 4 years he has scored a goal for the club. You're wondering what on earth was he doing on the park, but yes, he scored, and the whole team was on him on a turf, including the goalkeeper. Everybody was celebrating with him. Even opposition smiled. Mm. And it's because there's a player who never really scores until now. So, you just watch the games. You listen to a lot of commentary, because the facts, the statistics, the history that comes with it, it's immeasurable.
I see. I think what I'm going to do is this. I haven't yet made my mind up, but I think I like Leicester City.
Okay.
And the fact that I kept hearing a lot about Mo Salah, I followed a lot of his videos. And so he seems like a cool person too.
So you might go for Liverpool as well?
For Liverpool as well. And I heard about N'Golo Kante during the World Cup. Apparently he didn't take a photo with the crowd.
He took a photo with the World Cup, but he just didn't. He wasn't celebrating with the team when they won the World Cup. Until one player, Steven Nzonzi, had told a teammate, you know something, let him have a feel of the World Cup. Then he touched the World Cup. He was just there.
He's like a very shy person.
Very shy.
Yeah.
He's one of 9 children with African roots. Wow. And he says he minds his business.
Interesting. So maybe that's Chelsea, right?
Yeah, that's Chelsea.
So we're looking at Leicester City, Liverpool and Chelsea. They have matches coming up this weekend, right?
Great matches coming up.
So
there's one of the big games of the season is coming up this weekend, Chelsea versus Arsenal. Nice. That is always a cracking game to look at.
Okay. I think I'll be watching that as well.
Yeah.
So I guess
you might pick a few things from
I'll definitely do it. So I guess maybe we'll see this progress next week. Yeah. See where I'm
sure,
standing
should,
when the time
should,
comes up.
Sure, we should. Yeah. And hopefully on that day I will be asking the questions, not you.
Yeah, definitely.
Just so I measure, how far you've gone.
Yeah,
with this. Yes.
Definitely. But Theri, thank you very much for giving
pleasure.
Me this lesson.
Pleasure.
And hopefully next week would be more. We'll get more enlightening for me. As I watch more.
I mean, with these basics, all you need to do is just to make a choice, or decide to just watch a couple of games over the weekend, and you might be surprised. The club you choose. It might not be either Liverpool or Leicester City.
Okay. We'll see about that.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
All right, sure.
Anyway, you've been watching Tackle. Follow us on social media right here. And subscribe to our 3 Extra YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.